If you have already subscribed, then click the bell icon to get instant notifications when I put a new video up. Do it now. What's up guys, I'm Rob. Welcome to my channel. Now I know for sure that today's video will make you guys very happy because a lot of you have been flooding my comment section on my YouTube channel and on my Instagram with one common request. Please make the left and right trigger buttons of the mobile version of the game PUBG. Now honestly, I don't invest my time in video games anymore because I have important things to do in life. But because of you guys, I decided to figure out how PUBG works or what PUBG is. But I didn't download it on my phone. I checked with someone from my team so that I know what the game is and how I can make these buttons. And I can proudly say I have a very simple solution on how you can. So get ready, it's time for some DIY. Why? Because I love it. All right, let's get started. So I'm making the triggers using ice cream sticks because we are making this for the mobile and you need a material which is light and strong. And ice cream sticks are very light, very sturdy and very strong. So this is the perfect material for the triggers. So what you have to do is first you have to divide the ice cream stick into three parts. And this is how you do it. So here you can see I have made the markings. So let's remove this one. This part is 2.5 centimeters. This is 4 centimeters and this is 3 centimeters. And this little tiny piece we don't need. So when you cut it, you can throw this out. Now to cut this, you can either use scissors or a cutter, but we will do it with the power of editing. There you go, it's done. So you can see we have divided this into three parts. So these three parts we need and we can get rid of this one. Also, you would need one more 4 centimeter part. So in total, you should have one, which is 2.5 centimeters, two that are 4 centimeters and one that is 3 centimeters. And this whole set will make one trigger or one controller. So now I'm gonna show you guys how you can stick these to make your trigger. So first, what we're going to do is we're going to stick these two pieces together, the ones that are 4 centimeters long. Now to stick the ice cream sticks together, I am using super glue. You can take the super glue of any brand you like. If you don't have super glue, you can also use regular white glue. It just takes a little longer to stick. Now, super glue is slightly dangerous to work with because you can end up sticking your fingers, so be extra careful. So what I'm doing here is I'm applying a little bit, just few drops on the stick like that. And then I'm going to take the other piece and place that piece over this one very carefully. And gently press it down. Make sure you don't put extra on this because when you press the pieces together, it will squeeze out and it will just be all over your fingers and you might end up sticking your fingers. And I'm not kidding guys, this stuff is dangerous. You will either peel off all your skin or you will have to go to the doctor or the hospital to separate it. So be extra careful. But yes, this stuff is pretty instant. As you can see, the pieces are already ready. So I have glued these two pieces together. So this is ready. And what we'll do is we will stick one piece in the front like this and the other piece behind it like so. So again, I'm going to do the same thing. Apply just a drop on the side of this sandwiched piece and then place one of the pieces over it. Keep it pressed for a little while so that it sticks in place. Okay, so this is done. Now let's do the other side. Okay, there you go. As you can see, our piece is ready. So it looks something like this. Now this is basically a holder that will go over your phone. So ice cream stick is a perfect material to use for these triggers because the width of the ice cream stick matches approximately the width of or the thickness of a regular mobile phone. If your phone is slimmer than ice cream stick, then you can use a little bit of foam sheet on the inside. So I'll show you how this fits over a phone. Like I mentioned earlier, I don't have PUBG on my phone. So I'm using Rishi's phone, who's part of my team and he plays PUBG. So I'm gonna show it on his phone. So this is our trigger piece. piece, and this is how you can just slide it over the phone, and you can see it fits pretty well, and also you can move it around. It's not very tight. Right now, I'm pretty happy with this because I don't want it too tight right in the beginning, because I'm going to put some aluminum sheet and some tape on this, which will basically be a thick layer on each side, and that will make it slightly tighter. Okay, so our base is ready. So let's get the phone out. So now I'm going to show you guys how this piece made out of ice cream sticks can actually work like a trigger. So we have quite a bit of static charge in our body that is transferred through our finger onto the phone screen. That's how you can operate a lot of things using your finger. Now your finger will have to transfer that static charge onto the trigger to make it work. Now wood is not a good conductor. Now to pass that electric charge, I'm going to use aluminum foil. Now this is your regular aluminum foil that you use to wrap sandwiches or food, and we're going to take a small piece from this and use it on our trigger to make this active. So first what I'll do is I'll take some double-sided tape and I'm going to stick it onto the aluminum foil. Now you don't need a whole lot, maybe just a few inches. We'll take the tape and now I'll cleanly cut this. We are going to cut a thin strip that is going to go onto our trigger. Okay, so you can see I have this thin strip of aluminum with this sticky back. Now, before I stick this, we need to put a small piece of double-sided foam tape on one of the ends. So I have this thin double-sided tape. So this is a foam tape which is thicker than your regular double-sided tape. If you don't find this foam tape, you can use a small piece of foam sheet and you can stick it there with either white glue or super glue. So now I'm going to take a small piece, maybe like a centimeter or so, and I am going to stick this on the inside of one of the smaller vertical pieces, just like that. Now this foam tape will add a little bit of cushioning, and also this will hold my aluminum foil in place because this has sticky surface. So I'm gonna just peel the tape off like this. So here now I have my foam tape in place with the sticky side revealed. Now let's get the aluminum strip in right here. I will stick this on the foam sheet. There you go. Now we will continue this strip like that. So there you go. You can see I started with this side where the foam tape was and went over like that to the other side. Now actually you need it only till the top, so even if you put it till here, it's fine. So now this strip has basically made the wood conductive, and it will transfer the electric charge from my finger onto the mobile phone through this end. So our trigger is pretty much ready. We have a little extra piece of foam tape that is peeking out on either side. So either you can cut it using scissors or cutter, or you can put a piece of aluminum foil and cover this bit too, or just use some regular sticky tape and cover it so that this doesn't stick to your phone. But I'm just going to use my cutter and just cut this extra bit out. Okay, I'm done for one side. Do the same for the other side. Okay, so there you go, we are done. So our trigger is now ready. Now let's place it over the phone and check. So there you go, you can see that our trigger or a controller is ready. It fits well. Now it's a snug fit because of the foam tape I've put. Doesn't even move. So this is actually good to go and you can use it as is. But I have two problems with this. One, that every time you remove it and you place it, you can see that it leaves a little bit of mark. And that is not good. Although there is a cover on this and you can wipe it off, but to avoid that, you can actually put some tape over the aluminum foil so that it doesn't scratch your screen. And two, when you touch it, it will pass on the charge, but it doesn't feel like a button. It's like I'm hitting a surface. So to make the button, you can actually add a small lever on top, which you can keep hitting so it feels more like a button. So now we're going to do just that. Add a cover and a button. So for the cover, I'm using this tape. Now you can use any sticky tape you want. I like the black one, so I'm gonna cover this with the black tape. So here I have cut a small piece out and I am going to cover this whole aluminum sheet part with the tape. So I'll cover the whole piece like this, like that, and then just go around. So it's like a tiny sleeve or cover, and then using the scissors, you can just cut the extra bits off. So this is ready. So now we have solved one problem. The aluminum foil is not going to scratch your screen because now it has a guard or a cover on top of it. And now for the lever, I am going to use a small piece of elastic, which I've cut from an old file. The size is similar to the ice cream stick, which is 4 centimeters long and about 1 centimeter wide. If you don't have a file sheet, use any plastic cover or a bottle. Basically, you need a flexible piece, can be plastic, wood, whatever you want. And you can stick it on top like this. I'm going to stick it with a foam tape on one corner and then bend it slightly so that it remains up like this. And then this will act like a button that I can keep clicking. Now, like wood, plastic is also not a good conductor of electricity. And the same way we have put aluminum foil on the wood surface, we will stick some aluminum foil onto our plastic to make it conductive. Here, I've cut a small piece of aluminum foil with the sticky back, and I'm going to stick this on one of the sides like this, half on top and half on the bottom, so that when I touch it on top, the charge gets transferred to the bottom and it hits this part and the charge is transferred through this to the screen. Okay, let's peel it and stick it in place. Okay, so this is ready. Now we are going to bend this a little bit so that when I stick it, it stays up like that, and I can press it down like a button when I'm playing the game. And to stick it in place, I'm going to use foam tape. Here I've got a small piece of foam tape. Let's place it that, peel the cover to reveal the sticky surface, and then just align it and stick it in place. There you go. And now it's like a button because you're physically pressing something down, so it gives you like the feel of a button instead of just hitting the surface with your finger. So I like this better than just having the plain aluminum foil on the ice cream stick. So now you have two ways basically to make the trigger work. I am pleased with this one, so I'll stick to this one. Now let's place this on the top. So there you go. This is the left side trigger or controller. And similarly, I have made another one here for the right side. So let's slide that also in place. There you go, that's how you can make the trigger buttons for PUBG. Now you can go and waste all your time on a video game. Honestly, I don't have anything against video games. If you want to play games, then invest all your time in that. But I honestly feel that you should manage your time better, like do other things also. Go outdoors, go for a hike, go, I don't know, ride your bicycle, do some DIY, study, yeah? So manage your time, all right? Do let me know in the comments below if this worked for you and if you liked it. And if you did, then don't forget to give it a big thumbs up, like, share and subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. If you have, thank you. Also subscribe to my new vlog channel, Robin the Hood. Also, you can follow me on Instagram. Those are the two handles. Follow me there. And you can send in some more requests as ridiculous as this one. And I would love to fulfill them. All right, guys, that's the end of this video. I'll see you in my next one. Till then, do good and be good. Peace. Shh.